praise the United States lawyer with 42-year experience flying his 1978 Cessna 182 plane, had failed to register that there was a problem with the fuel tanks. He was too slow in a bank turn, so the plane rolled left in a spiral stall. At 120 meters above the ground, he was going down fast. Fortunately, his Cessna was equipped with a simple but clever technology. As the ground loomed, he pulled the handle just above his hand. There was a huge impact and everything went black. I thought I was dead. Then a second, more violent impact as the plane fell out of the top of trees, Fraser recalls. He survived with a sprained back. What saved Fraser's life was a parachute capable of carrying the whole plane. It slowed his descent just enough. This type of parachute is found on many light aircraft. Some manufacturers and engineers argued that if they were installed on commercial airlines, the lives of hundreds of people could be saved. So why haven't aircraft companies embraced the idea for all planes? The answer may be obvious. Whole plane parachutes are more suitable in a crisis because they can be deployed quickly. That's why about 10% of all small general aviation planes are equipped with a single chute that carries the plane with its passengers and cargo. On small planes like Cessna or Cirrus, the parachute is stored in the fuselage either behind the back seat or in the center section of the wing, above the cockpit. And in emergency, the pilot has to pull a handle in the ceiling of the plane. Once the large chute deploys, the descent rate is about 500 meters per minute, so impact you'd expect on the ground is equivalent to jumping from a 4-meter tall ledge, says Travis Klump, Cessna's director of flight operation. Planes are also equipped with other features that help cushion the drop, such as crushable aluminium inside the seats and landing gear designed for a controlled collapse during a crash landing. One of the main manufacturers of whole plane chutes is Ballistic Recovery System, based in Miami, Florida. Founder Boris Popov started his company after a glider he was flying as a young man spun out of control. He plunged into lake from about 150 meters. His survival inspired him to seek ways to make aviation safer. The biggest planes equipped with the BRS parachutes are for 5 people, but Popov is planning to install parachutes on planes up to 20 passengers within the next 5 years. He believes that, in principle, you could install them on much bigger aircraft, perhaps even large passenger planes. There is no doubt that big commercial airlines of the future will be equipped with some kind of a parachute recovery system, he says. Yet is this a realistic prospect? Many say that technologically it's possible to equip an airliner with a parachute, but you have to ask whether there's any real value in doing it. Certainly, you would lose a very large amount of the airliner's payload, so you'd have to reduce the number of passengers you can carry very significantly. All the safety features available on aircraft have been selected on the basis of what is the most likely to save lives for a given amount of money and a given amount of weight. The spokesman for the United Kingdom Civil Aviation Authority isn't convinced that a parachute would always help either. It is rare that all engines stop, and if only one stops, the pilot can still, in majority of cases, land the plane. When a plane does stall, there might not be enough time to deploy a parachute anyway, he adds. Finally, it would be difficult to design a parachute system big enough to carry the weight of a commercial airliner. The largest Airbus A320 380 can carry up to 853 people and weighs nearly 400 times as much as a small personal aircraft. And that doesn't include passengers and luggage. Any parachute systems on an Airbus would have to be very large indeed and compromise multiple candidates, says Elise Ginley, a media relations manager at Airbus. The system would be complex, bulky and heavy and require multiple safety devices to make unintentional deployment impossible. Still, if you were to build a parachute system that could carry a large plane, what would it take? To safely bring down a big commercial airline such as Boeing 747 with about 500 people on board, there would have to be 21 parachutes, each the size of a football field, says Popov. It takes about 0.1 square meter of material to bring down 0.5 kilograms of aircraft. This would likely be unfeasible. So, to decrease the number of canopies, one solution could be to ditch all the heavy parts of the plane in emergency, such as the wings and the engines, says Popov. The parachutes would rescue the passenger cabin only. Breton agrees that shifting weight would be the best method, albeit an extreme one. If we had to do it, then getting rid of wings and engines is the right thing to do. I just hope you don't do it over a city, he says. The idea has been considered before, though. A detachable cabin was first proposed by Russian inventor Gleb Kotelnikov in 1920s. He's credited with inventing the first knapsack parachute, which was later used by the Soviet military in World War II. Kotelnikov's design never went beyond paper calculations, but the main Russian Parachute Manufacturing Institute, the Scientific Research Institute of Parachute Design and Production, NIE Parashutostroyenie, is busy developing an airplane parachute recovery system. It is partly based on Kotelnikov's 9-decades-old idea. One design consists of cutting the wings of the special blades and then separating the passenger's cabin into several modules with the parachute attached to each. This parachute system can also be used to drastically reduce speed and avoid human casualties during take-off and landing accidents, says the Institute's chef designer Viktor Lyon. The downside is that they won't be able anytime soon because they require extensive redesign of the aircraft. Popov demands that within this century, all planes of all sizes will have parachute recovery system. All it will take is public will. A lot of people keep asking, why can't I have the parachute system on the Boeing 737 when I fly to see my grandma? Well, if enough people ask for that, it will force the aircraft manufacturers and the governments to make these revolution changes. To my concern, I believe that while parachutes appear to be unlikely to arrive on large planes anytime soon, it may at least be possible in the future. Thank you for your attention.
Any questions from the audience? The members of the jury? So, I'd like to comment on your presentation, because that was great. I think that is a deep analysis for a good visual just support that I see. But to your mind, is it a really effective way to protect passengers, pilots from any kind of emergencies? Or should we just think about anything else?
I think this is the best idea. As we know, the plane is the safest type of vehicle right now, the present. But we can make it more safer with this technology, like VRS, because nothing more effective.
Okay, got it. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yes, guys, we need just to measure. That's a second. Okay, support our speaker. And it sounds like there will be managers to wash it. Are you ready with this? Okay. So, the question is.